All right. Good evening, everyone. We are about to interview Mr. Sandro Dernini, the very first Time Artist of the Year, but better, I should say, the Artist of the Century. When we say Time, we don't mean Time magazine. We mean the Time Life, you know, Her Majesty the Time Life. All right, how you doing, sir?
Time is escaping. I'm doing something for the first time to present myself inside the Campbell soup can, so it's no easy mission.
It's not. But that's why I'm here, to supporting you. And Sandro is an artist who realized many years ago that you could sculpt time or draw time, as you can sculpt a block of marble or draw on a blank sheet of paper. And so he began to shape his days, and in particular a series of events. Okay, this is how Plexus was born. A time art movement that is now 40 years old, in which a number of artists have come and go. How and when did the adventure begin?
1982 in New York. Plexus was a performance space in the Lower East Side, then moved and then escaped from the art world of New York, moving the Lower East Side community, black, Puerto Rican, and going to Sardinia, to Dakar, to the House of the Slave, Rome, Australia, Amsterdam, Sardinia, Rio de Janeiro, Jerusalem, involving more than 1,000 artists with more than 100 art events.
A real melting pot.
Very compressed.
Very complex.
And non-linear.
No, non-linear, no. Rounded, I should say. Rounded, non-linear.
Non-linear.
And not limited.
No, metaphoric.
Unlimited.
Unlimited, metaphoric.
Yeah.
Time's capsule.
So, Mr. Dernini once said, if you do not have time to live your life, then you are a slave of someone else's time. Do you still believe it?
Really, thanks a lot, Glauco.
That's okay. Then
for a perfect question. We started by considering time as a gravity, something that keep you prisoner, the time gravity. To escape from gravity, we felt to use the purgatorio entrance, because in the purgatorio is the only dimension which exists time. The hell and the paradise is forever. But time became the measurement of today human bill market. You are by time of people, and we felt from New York to escape from time through the purgatorio show with the 220 artists, the 350 artists, and then linking, chain together us as a slave of art, escape from Anno Domini, Anno Domini. The history it is written, but it's not the reality of life, the written history. So we felt to go in the door of no return, of the house of the slave, and to position us in time scale, the door of no return. Art slavery, Plexo manifesto that collect a group shot around the world, Andre. Now we are time capsule. We are basically building from the past, realizing the present, and projecting to the future in one single moment of time.
Great. Now, today Plexus is a container, is a big container.
The Campbell soup.
Where and in which pieces of time art as we can see around, we'll show it later. Inside this container, pieces of timer are portrayed, apparently unorganized, apparently, but instead coherent, one to the other, to form a single work of art. Can you describe this to help people understand?
Just to make a very simple example. Plexus, in 40 years, building one event to another one, he felt to dematerialized by sending rematerialized digital artwork from 2004 to 2019, sending digital JPEG, reproducing in xerocopy, format A3, glued together, building a metrart, long metrart, to measure metaphor like freedom, peace, human right, planet Earth. 700 artists participate, it's a long 400 meter. The last event was for the Basilica of San Francis in Assisi in Italy, for peace. Today, again, for peace.
I remember, I was one of them.
That is a collective work, but the Plex is not a collective. It's an adventure of artists, the first person producer independent, like British label. It's a framework that wanted, contested, the only right of the art world to confer the artistic identity. Why not also the community? The community can confer the artistic identification. So, yeah. But in a time, like so 40 years, is just introducing the issue. It is this art world an expression of art, or it is more an expression of an art market, of a market, not take out art, of a market. The art world is market. A human being, a commodity symbol. Time, it is the measure of a slavery now. You buy the person, you buy his time. The artist, the time art.
Television steals time, mostly, no?
We are.
Television steals time. Every time you watch, they steal your time. But which were the most epic events? Now, you mentioned the Metrart, which it was one of the very epical events. But then you have so many others, vibrant times, like...
Like, for example, Easy, the Plexus International Art Slavery, Rivington School, and many friends from the United States they are following now, Rivington School, Plexus Art Slavery Manifesto group shot, that was calling of a group shot around the world for freedom of art, and we collect in Rome 100 historical avant-garde artists together in front of that picture made in New York, moving to Sardinia in the Elizabeth boat in Carlo Forte, St. Peter Island, going to the Colosseum, going to the house of the slaves of Gorée, and they started to carry work of art for an utopic vision. The creation of an art world bank managed and produced by the artists that are investing with their artwork history. Because 40 years, all documented, it is a segment unexplored of a contemporary art history. They like or don't like the art world, we belong to art history.
We do belong.
We belong
to art history. All right, but you know, all this sounds, not a bit, more than a bit, sounds like a situationism, you know. In a way, there are a lot of echoes of the situationist. Do you agree?
I agree with
you. Do you agree?
Plexus, yes. It is a situationist.
Yeah. Can you explain what it means?
Basically, Plexus never accepted any definition. He refused to be a group, to be a movement. But of course, he belongs to art history, to contemporary art history. And we are coming from those that already prepared the ground. There was called Fluxus, but then there was Situationist. The Situationist, they were more related to the political context of a revolution that we were in the 60s. In the 60s was also, fighting against the system, not accepting the system. The situation is that they were really fighting against it. And then, Plexus never said that we are situationists, but we are coming from the last one that were the situationists. Before was the Flux, before was the Dada, before was the Futurism.
Yeah, we are as well situationists. As well. Now, you said, before you said, we didn't like to get a name, no? We didn't like to be defined. Yes, your name is Sandro Dernini, but now you have an artist name. Now that sounds like 23S.
Plexus 23S.
Plexus 23S. And what do you expect from the future, like Plexus 23S?
I don't know if the video camera can follow me. If I move, I am asking to the director if I can show what means the future of 23S. This is not my artistic name. It is my historical identification inside the Plexus International. Yeah. Each one was wanted to be identified because we didn't like a group, we didn't like a movement, and we didn't like, already we were individual. So inside also Plexus, since the beginning, like when we started, well, I was Plexus 23S.
So to be, before the very famous group, you wanted to be anonymous.
I wanted to be Sandro Dernini as a Plexus 23S, but before it was necessary to have a 40 years credit line for individual artists, because like me, there are other hundred artists with their artistic identification.
All right. Now, I don't know if the camera is ready to move. I stay here. No, you can.
This it is, the Plexus strategy map, it in art, and this is simple. If you was made best art slavery, Mark Shaw a Gavoi in Sardinia, 1987, coming from New York, and there is the video too, that it is the marketing mix strategy in which there is a brainstorm, Plexus Network Dakar, A, B, C, D, E, an artist. But become A1, B, B1, C, C1, by interacting the contest with the others. Then A1 is not anymore A1, become A2. B become a B2, and so far is a
evolution. Let's go back to the track, believe me. Yeah, yeah. No, don't go too much out of the track. Show something else.
No, I prefer to sit because...
That was enough. Okay.
That is the strategy. Each one of us interact with the contest with the others.
All right.
We become co-producers.
All right. Now, can you imagine founding a Time Art Academy?
We spoke many time about this issue. I think that many experience in the past, they were self-referential in some way. I believe that right now we are moving to a Plexus room.
Okay.
A Plexus room, it is like a setting. I don't want to say an escape room, but in
it's
which...
It's like the one in which we are now. It's like
it's an escape room, a plexus room in which you can travel through some enigma, like this apple, and get some prize, some award. And that can create, of course, we are talking dematerialized sea, digital sea. We are totally data, we are totally part of the system, digital, but we are human. So there is necessary to have a place where there is a human touch.
Yeah, human, a proper mix between physical and numerical. Physical, you have to touch something.
You have to touch.
You have to touch, yes. I understand. Now, let's go to the crucial point of tonight. The team, the Campbell song, no?
Yes.
Tell us something about this new work you've done, this the Campbell Souk revisited, or what?
Okay, it's the first time that I'm presenting a work of Art of B. Mm. It's my first time that I'm presenting my own work. This work I started in 1988 in New York. And I finished just for this vernissage, 2023, make that it took me 35 years to prepare this time capsule art, a limited edition of 100, on 100.
Which is this?
That is this. Never it was issued yet. This Campbell Soup, there's a Q code.
QR code,
in which there is all this story that I'm just said to you, but it's too long. Basically, Andy Warhol dematerialized, it is written here. On the back, it is a direction, eating art.
Eating, this is important.
Eating art. Ingredients,
eating.
History of Modern Art, Volume 1, Food Art International, Plexus 23S, Soup Can.
Ah, show the work of art to the camera, yeah. Like what? What's wrong? No, you have no more audio.
Okay. This was made, the label, by a printer in New York, Ram Studio of Maggie Reilly. The design was Robert Kerr. This was the result of a performance phenomenological inquiry for New York University, where I was taking my PhD that I was granted in 1997 on phenomenology. If it was possible to eat Andy Warhol by eating a Campbell Soup can for a symposium on dematerialization of art of the International Center of Advanced Study of Art in case of New York University, using the brochure of the symposium that was happening the day after as a napkin to clean our mouth after eating a Campbell Soup can and compiling a test, a questionnaire. The majority said that we ate Andy Warhol. It was reported to the International Symposium, Jean Baudrillard, Nan June Paik, Vita Concha, Nan June Paik said, yes, you have dematerialized Andy Warhol as in your intentional action. This is what I did 35 years later. I put inside this Campbell Soup the strategic map of eating art. This is crawl. Then, what I did, basically, this I like anyway, because I dematerialized myself. I dematerialized myself inside the camber soup because it was how art was investigated inside the Academy of New York University. In all the academy, art it is investigated as a really like a positivistic science methodology. And in this way, art became easily and commodity and a human being.
Et voilà.
I put myself inside a camel soup.
Let's not dramatize. Not dramatize. Not too much. Tell me now. Did you eat Andy Warhol in the end?
They ask all the time.
Of course.
They are doing also, I hope that it goes through Stephen Di Lauro in New York. They are also making a movie, okay?
About the
about this story.
The cannibal art.
I must say that yes.
Oh.
I can really admit.
Yeah,
that I dematerialized in the world as a dematerialized food. As now we became food dematerialized in this cannibalistic society in which we are living, and it's not acceptable, the human use of the human being. Therefore, in my intentional action of eating and dematerialized food, I dematerialized Andy Warhol by rematerializing the concept of food. Food, it is a real entity. We can dematerialize Andy Warhol, eating Andy Warhol, and then producing again some object that it is for the community to establish a credit line for a project that still exists in the Medina of Dakar, of the children, the Atelier of Art, in which since many time ago, and we were together in 2000, raised the debt, dropped the debt with the money of art. This is something that need to bring back this not independence of the art world from the market to inside all the other component of the society, in which also Andy Warhol, that is an icon of a consumerism, it is digested by the reality that smell badly. Smell very badly this culture, this art world. Art, it is life, cannot become a commodity like and people, a human being, cannot be not the owner of its own time or her own time.
All right. Do you want to say anything else, or you think we can stop here? How much time did we go?
5 minutes.
Five minutes. 25. You have 5 minutes left.
Exactly.
To go to 30.
You.
I have to.
You can say. I'm emotional.
Yeah. No. Is there any questions made by the audience? We have so many people around looking at us. Come on. Make the question in French, in Spanish, in Italian, then we translate. No. Yes, sir. You want to know what? How much money we earn. He wants to know how much money you earned.
Okay, €100, $100 for the artist proof. In the entrance, there are 3 copies that they can be buy. If we don't have really, I would like to show the setting of the place. It is possible closing as the end, or is not possible?
But not now. Let's move all together.
Yeah,
we have to move all together. Okay. I follow you with the microphone.
Okay, thanks.
Come on.
Here, make a close up here, please. Eh? No, però si può fare, no.
No, you have to go the other way around, not this way.
No,
he cannot, and he cannot follow you this way.
No, io preferisco rimanere, non c'è nessuno, è brutto da vedere. Ciao! È stato bel Glauco!
But what a end. Come on, and the money keeps rolling in from everywhere. Bye.
Bene, c'era bene. C'era bene.